Hey, what's up, ladies? It's Lorraine here. So I've been getting a lot of requests for people, from people asking me if I can actually show how I usually do my braid outs. So that's what this video is about today. I'm gonna show you guys how I did it. So I just pretty much came from washing my hair. I was doing conditioner washes throughout the week, but today I did an actual shampoo. And what I'm going to be using on my hair, I'm going to be using Neutrogena Triple Moisture Silk Touch Leave-In. I'm going to use this. I'm going to use some Giovanni Vital Profusion. I'm going to use this. And I'm going to use a little bit of, this is just olive oil and vitamin E, nothing special. So I'm going to use that. So the first thing, I'm just going to spray on my Vita Pro. Spray this on all over. Getting everywhere. Getting the very tips. Okay, then I'm going to use my Neutrogena. Gonna put about that much on. I'm just gonna spread it throughout my entire hair, really focusing in on the roots, focusing in on the whole hair. I'm just gonna add a little bit more. Really making sure that I get the hair very good. Okay, now when you guys saw my other braid out, I didn't have a bang, but this week I want to put a bang, so I'm just going to make a chart here for a bang. I'm drunk as a skunk, feeling all dirty. Truck stop bathroom at 7:30. Order some dessert, give a damn if it's early. And again, we'll start like from about it says you don't the end it. And work your way shorty, I'm your up to the roof. Make sure that the ends are on. Very good. Take my cup, put it at one end. Take my other clip, put it at the other end, voila. Now to start off my braid out, I'm gonna make a part here. Down the middle. Don't ask me, officer, ask her. Want another drink, baby, she likes her. Want to hit the club, she like, I don't care. She all in the rear view doing a hurt. Maybe I want to make a bigger spray lip gloss everywhere. This all happens on an average day. Your life okay, is a trip, this is going to be the first section that we're going to do. Even though I had to pay. The rest of the hair, I'm just going to pin it up.
Everybody put your hands in the air.
Okay. So I'm gonna make two braids here. I'm gonna make one on the top and one on the bottom. So I'm gonna make a part down the middle, just like that. And I'm gonna take my oil, and again, this is vitamin E and this is olive oil. I'm gonna put a little bit on my hand. Then when it got a beamer, then I'm gonna her mom spread called me a D-boy. She said, yes, she is a dreamer. Two
making
tickets to
sure
the man.
Me
and Shorty way back in the day.
Very, very, very good.
She's in the films. I think then I'm gonna take the end. And this is a comb that I'm using for my braid out. Gonna take the end and just lightly work my way up. Baby. I gotta keep it
short. When I'm doing the braid out, I wanna make sure that the hair is very nice and smooth. So you just wanna bring that comb through very, very lightly. Dice in my pocket, I'm with CeeLo. Pull it to the crib and I ain't on. nice and good now. Okay. Now when my hair is like this, pretty much what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a braid. So you wanna make sure that the braid is as close to the root as possible. And you also wanna make sure that you're very gentle. You don't wanna make the braid very, very tight. You just wanna make it as close to the roots as possible. And you just braid it to the very, very end. Now, if you want like a looser look, you could do the braids very, very loose. Okay, it just depends on the look that you're going for. So I'm just braiding this down to the very, very end, making sure that the ends is not untangled or anything as we're braiding. And you can also do a braid out while your hair is dry. And you can pretty much, you can just like re-wet the hair a little bit, put a little bit of moisturizer, a little bit of leave-in conditioner, and re-wet the hair. But I like to do it when it's wet. It's just my preference. But like I said, you can do it also when the hair is dry. And I like this style because pretty much you can wear this throughout the whole week. You can pin it up, pin it back, let it hang down. And you don't have to really comb your hair or anything. You still moisturize your hair. You still put a little oil and a little moisturizer on your hair. But you don't have to comb through it and you don't have to wrap it. So this is pretty much what I do. Okay. This is the first braid. And I'm going to do another braid here. Then I'm going to do another braid. One, two, right here as well. So again, I put my oil on, rub it all throughout the hair, put it on the roots, put it on the ends, make sure I get those ends very good. And I'm going to show you the ending result when I have all the braids done. So I'm going to do a braid here, a braid here, here, and pretty much I just do a braid here. And a braid there. That's it. That's really pretty much how I do my braid. I don't do millions of braids or anything like that. If you would like to get more of a texturized look than a whole, like a real big fluffy look, you can do a lot of braids and you can just like loosen up all the braids. Okay, so I'm gonna be back and show you guys the result of all the braids braided up, okay? The scarf also flattens the new growth. So if you have a lot of new growth, the scarf actually flattens it. And I just want to say that this is not the only way to do a braid out. You can do it with caramels coming down. You can just do it so many different ways. You could be creative, put the part to the side. It just depends on how you want to do it and the way that's comfortable and easy for you. Hey, what's up everyone? So I wanted to show the end results of the braid out. And here it is. Basically just took out the braids and that's it. Just fluffed it out. And here's the results. So you guys can see it. So if you have any questions, any comments, just let me know and I'll be glad to answer it. And thank you to all my subscribers. I really appreciate it, all right? Take care, everyone. Bye.